funny comedian. He's got a new podcast. It's called Get Some. Please welcome Gary Owen. Hi. Yeah. Oh, you're ready?
Right on there.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
You're eager for this shoe cam. What are they, brand new? Go ahead now.
I've had them.
Okay, turn around. Anyone special that we should be talking about who made them or got them for you?
What are they? Landvin? Am I pronouncing it right?
Landvin.
Landvin?
Uh-huh.
L-A-N-V-I-N?
Yes.
I don't know.
Did you get them yourself or did your wife? Because I knew she has impeccable
My wife shoes. Got them.
Yes.
I don't buy nothing.
Do you have a lot of shoes?
Not compared to my wife, no.
Yeah?
No.
Well,
She's got the Avid collection.
Oh, wow.
That's only half the closet. Oh. And there's like two shoes in every one of those boxes.
Wow.
Yeah, and the boxes cost money.
Yeah. So that's well, like... it's good to be Mrs. Owens.
Right.
Owen. I always call, yeah. It's good to be Mrs. Owen. Uh-huh. Gary, you've been married for a long time.
Yeah, well, what is it, 2019? It'll be 16 years in July. 16 years in July. Nice.
And the children? How old are they?
Well, they're all older than the wedding. So, my daughter was the flower girl and my son was the ring bearer.
Oh.
Yeah, and then her oldest actually walked her down the aisle because her father passed away, so it was like a family affair.
Nice. Gary, you know, we talked about your lovely wife on Hot Topics.
What'd she do?
Well, she got profiled on the airplane.
Oh, yeah, Delta.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. So she was flying. Yeah, she was flying from Cincinnati to San Francisco. And the gate agent at B21 this particular day asked her if she was in first.
Now, were you all together as a family?
No, it's her and my daughter.
Okay.
So I didn't know this was happening. So she's like, there's all white dudes. She was the only black lady.
Okay.
He asked her, and she goes, are you going to ask anybody else? He said, no. She said, well, why not? He goes, because I don't have to. And then he took her ticket and he said, and I was not profiling you, right?
Oh.
So I don't know what's happening. So I pick her up in San Francisco and my daughter, who's the militant one in the family.
Okay.
Like I call her Kennedy Kaepernick.
Okay,
she's
okay.
Serious about her stuff. That one. Get ready. Whatever university she goes to, get ready. She can be leading all the protesters and the marches.
So what'd she do?
She's like, tell him, Ma. Tell him. I'm like, what did I do? Now I'm on all the social media sites, like on my phone, like, oh snap, did I do something? And then she tells me this story, and I'm like, and then here's my daughter, what you gonna do about it, Dad? What are you gonna do about it? I was like, do what white people do, make a post. What am I doing? I'm gonna send some goons? Yeah, I'm about to handle this. Get back on the plane to Cincinnati. Make an Instagram post.
And your post is actually how we got it.
Yeah, and then Delta reached out, and the lady called us and said they're gonna send a gift. They felt bad. Still haven't got anything yet. We're waiting. We're waiting, Delta. We're waiting.
So I heard.
I just did what white guys do. I called you out.
I called you out. I've known of you for a while. I mean, you know, we were both in Think Like a Man and stuff like that. And you've been here on the show. But I do a little research on you. And you know, he's only dated black women.
Yeah.
What is that all about? Explain.
Well, how do you explain it? I always say, like, it's like being gay.
Okay.
Like, a gay guy knows he's gay at an early age.
Okay,
know? But a lot of times, gay guys, they don't say nothing growing up because they're scared of people going to say about them. I was the same way. I didn't tell nobody like black girls when I was growing up. But I knew I was different. You know? I went to a high school that was predominantly white. We didn't have a lot of black girls at the school.
Okay.
Right? And then I remember I was in the military and I'm 18 and a bunch of my military buddies took me out to a nightclub and like four black girls walked in together.
Uh-huh.
I about lost my mind.
Okay.
I was hitting people. Yo! I'm getting nothing out of them.
Right.
I'm over here trying to flex in the corner.
Right. So they weren't receiving what you were throwing. But your wife did. How'd you meet her? Am I screaming?
That's all right.
I'm sorry.
No, Shaquille O'Neal introduced us.
Really?
Yeah, she worked for, when Shaq played for the Lakers, he had a clothing line called Twism.
Right.
She worked at Twism.
Right, right.
And he brought his staff out to a comic club one night, and I was like an open micer.
Right.
And I met her, and I asked her on a date, and I remember our first date, we went to, she wanted me to take her to Crustaceans in Beverly Hills.
Mmm, they've got the good noodles.
The garlic noodles.
Shut
yeah.
up.
So I got an S10 pickup with a crack in the windshield, and I'm circling around Crustaceans, and she's like, what are you doing? I was like, looking for a parking spot. She goes, just valet. I said, oh, we can't do both. No, we can't. I can't valet and take you to Crustaceans. You can choose one or the other. So we parked like a half a mile away. We walked those noodles off.
So... do you play golf? Because I heard you're very excited about Tiger Woods.
I am, man. It's just a great comeback story. And I don't think we,
Yeah.
Yeah. I think as a sports fan, as the older I get, I just learn to appreciate greatness
yes.
as it is.
Uh-huh.
And with how he's come back like he has. Uh-huh. And not just the cheating scale. I'm talking about the back surgeries and everything else.
Yes.
But I will say, the universe has a way of balancing things out because, you know, Tiger, he's got a lot of money. He's a great golfer and physically fit. He looks amazing.
He does.
He's over 40.
Uh-huh.
When he takes off that hat. Yeah. That is... If that is God, that is God in the universe balancing things out. Like, Tiger, we can give you all this, but you ain't getting all of it. You know, he took that, because that hat came, literally when he won, I was like, yeah, put it back
yes,
on.
Yes,
put it back on,
yes,
baby.
Yes.
Put it back on.
I was talking about that yesterday in Hot Topics. Did you see the back? They're like bald spots. It's spotty. And
yeah.
He knows no better.
Well, he literally went from like 30 to 48 in an instant. Like, boop, boop, you know? Woo,
so,
Tiger.
So Gary's got a new movie. It's called Little.
No, I'm not.
I was trying to rub it in.
So here's what happened. There's a movie called Little out right now. So, yeah, whatever. So Will Packer, who's the producer, who also was the producer of Think Like a Man
yeah.
and Ride Along, which I've worked with him numerous times, he called me to offer me a part in Little. So I was also shooting a pilot, and it just so happened they were shooting at the same time.
No. Shooting a pilot for the Gary Owen show. It was gonna be a sitcom.
Yeah.
As you could see, that was really, really funny. Now, what network were you shooting it for?
It was just gonna be syndicated.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, you don't even wanna talk about it. You're so mad, because they didn't end up picking it up.
No, they didn't pick it up, but you gotta make a decision.
No, don't roll over that, because you are sitcom material.
Well, you gotta...
No, you have to make a decision.
Movie
so,
or
right,
sitcom?
Or your own sitcom.
Yeah, so it's like...
So you
it's like
you chose your sitcom.
Well, I chose it... Let me put it like this.
Oh.
If I would have had the Regina or Issa Rae role...
Right.
I would have probably taken the movie.
Okay.
But I was just in the movie
okay.
for like a week but, of shooting.
But still, people would remember you. You're the white guy.
Yeah, a little... but the pie didn't get picked up. And that's just all it is. It's a roll of the dice. You know, I gambled on myself and it didn't, but other things will happen.
Who better to gamble on?
Yeah, but yeah. it's like now that the movie's come out and they're promoing it, I keep texting Will like, could you stop, please? You stop promoing the movie? Because I feel like every time they're promoing it, they're going, you could have been in this, Gary.
Yeah.
This could have been you.
Like yeah, this. But you know what? Something must have been wrong with the people who didn't, you need a sitcom. At the very least, if it's not going to be your own, you need to be a buddy sitcom or something like that. Like,
yeah.
How about a sitcom about your life? Because that sounds funny.
Yeah, we tried it. We tried it a couple times. I walked away from one deal. I had a deal at Fox years ago, and I thought the show was a good idea. Mm. And then when we got the script, uh-huh. it was like, everything was racial. Like, all the jokes were black, white.
Right.
That's fine every now and then, but that's not the show.
Yes.
So literally, I just walked away from the deal. I was
right.
like, I can't be on the air with a show like this.
I just can't do it. Something's gonna come around good for you. And by the way, congratulations on the podcast. Gary has a podcast, real quick, because they're wrapping me up. Please tell me about it.
Yeah, I like the podcast because, you know,
the good thing about
it's called Get Some, hashtag Get Some. And I just like the podcast community because it's very supportive.
Yeah.
It's unlike TV where it's kind of competitive with ratings and everything.
Oh, yeah.
Podcasts, if you hear a good podcast, you want to go on it and hopefully they'll come on yours.
Yeah.
I just like it. It is like its own little community. So yeah. I like doing the podcast.
So you check that out, everybody. That's called Get Some with Gary Owen. That's his podcast. Go to wendyshow.com.